Hi, this is William Hawkins from the PIX4D training team, and in this video, we will show how to georeference a project in PIX4Dmatic with ground control points, GCPs, and an arbitrary coordinate system. Let's get started. Arbitrary or local coordinate systems are typically used in construction sites or in mining. The origin of the system is based on arbitrary, also known as local, points and is not aligned with any known coordinate system. We will select the arbitrary CRS and units, meters, feet, or feet US, of the GCPs, as well as mark GCPs and images early or later in the process depending on your preferred method. Please keep in mind the format of the arbitrary GCPs locations must be in XYZ, meter, feet, or feet US. The recommended workflow, method A, is to create a project and import images. In the Select the GCP Coordinate Reference System, CRS, click Arbitrary CRS and select the units. Import the GCPs. Mark a minimum of 3 GCPs on images. More could be marked if you wish. Then run the calibrate step. Benefit of this workflow is that there is no need to rerun the calibrate step. The downside is that since the position of images and GCPs are not aligned, it is not possible to get a rough position of GCPs on the images, and it can consequentially take longer to locate and mark each GCP. It helps to have some sort of reference to be able to locate GCPs on the images. For example, dropping pins in a mapping app on your phone or tablet as you deploy the GCPs can be useful. You can reference the pins on the map and compare to the images you collected to help locate each GCP. An alternative workflow, method B, calls for you to create a project and import images. In the Select GCP Coordinate Reference System, CRS, click Arbitrary CRS and select the units, which is similar to method A. The difference between the two methods is that now you run the calibrate step. Mark at least 3 MTPs in the exact area where the GCPs appear. In the tie points table, change the type of marked MTP to GCP and manually insert their coordinates. You then rename the MTPs to the actual name of the GCP in the import file. Rerun the calibrate step by selecting the reoptimized cameras. Import and mark any additional GCPs. And finally, rerun the calibrate step by selecting the reoptimized cameras. The benefit of this workflow, method B, is that the project is first georeferenced based on a small amount of GCPs. This way, images and GCPs are roughly aligned, and it is easier to detect and mark additional GCPs. By first calibrating the project, the Run Auto GCP algorithm is enabled, which can additionally speed up the marking of GCPs. More information about arbitrary coordinate systems is available in the support documentation. We hope that this tutorial was helpful. See you in another video.